Time for us to go behind enemy lines with the Chicago Bears, presented by Microsoft Teams. Mike Keith, Amy Wells, joined by the voice of the Chicago Bears, Jeff Joniak. Jeff, thanks for the time.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for having me on. Looking forward to Sunday.
Bears, an intriguing team at 5-3. I want to start off asking you specifically about offense and the quarterback position. Nick Foles has sort of taken over from Mitchell Trubisky, and you would say he's the guy.
Absolutely, and they're going to live with this right now and try and work things out offensively. They haven't had a lot of time together, still learning his receivers and his weapons and learning the new play caller in his headset, putting this system into place and working with his targets right now. And the offensive line has had some health issues, so that's been unsteady. The running game has not been working. It got better against the Saints. There are things starting to develop. The field's starting to open up, but they have not been able to attack teams horizontally and vertically in the same game and actually, you know, keep sustained drives and score touchdowns.
I want to get your assessment of rookie wide receiver Darnell Mooney. What have you seen from him and his development this season?
He came in with a lot of confidence about his route running and his ability to make big plays, and he's made big plays. In fact, he owns the biggest play of the year for the Bears, the 50-yard pass that he beat Janoris Jenkins on in the loss to the Saints. But for me, the big picture is he truly wants to be a perfect route runner, and he wants to run the entire route tree. So with that kind of confidence and that kind of work ethic, that means big things down the road.
Let's talk linebacker Roquan Smith. Is he having an all-star caliber year?
I really believe he is, Mike. He's an outstanding cover backer, and there are times, obviously, that every linebacker is going to get beat in coverage, but he makes up for any defeat on a guy catching a pass by using his speed and range to track a guy down. He's a very good tackler. He is really triggering fast this year, really doing a great job sniffing out screens, undercutting blocks, coming downhill, and tracking down some of the very best players in the league, including Alvin Kamara in the second half on Sunday. He was outstanding.
Now, you can't talk about the Chicago Bears defense without talking about Khalil Mack. Where is his presence being felt the most in the 2020 season?
In every way possible. I mean, he's a guy you must account for and know where he is. They're lining him up in several places. He's on a sack streak right now that puts him at 6.5. He is a quiet leader on this team, but the players really feed off of his energy, and he is a tough out for any offensive lineman.
Thank you so much for joining us right here on our Behind Enemy Lines segment presented by Microsoft Teams.